Hi, in this video we will talk about how to call other contracts. One benefit of having a blockchain is to have access to other contract APIs deployed on this blockchain. As you may know, DeFi dApps are called by many contracts, and also DeFi apps are calling a lot of oracles. All these worlds live together and need to interact with each other. There are several ways for contracts to interact with each other. The first way is to use inter-contract calls, via internal transactions. The second way is to use on-chain views. You have to keep in mind that internal transactions are costly and are paid by the user. Transaction updates the state of the smart contract and requires the context to be loaded. Another point about inter-contract calls is that they break the sequential execution of the function. Your contract function has to be split into several parties, and if you want to have something that looks like sequential, you will have to play with callbacks. It brings two problems, the complexity and the cost. That's why we will see at the end of this video an example with on-chain views. It is one of the ways to solve this problem. So let's start with a simple example. For example, sending a transaction with money to an implicit account is one of the ways of interacting with another contract. I will take as example the one described in the Tezos documentation to do inter-contract calls and take the code of the smart contract. So here in this example, the global scenario is to have user calling a smart contract 1, calling a smart contract 2 with a callback back to the smart contract 1. I will take this code, do a simple transfer to show you how to do an interaction with an implicit account, and then I will try to implement this scenario. So I'm creating this file and I'm copying the code. So that's the code that you should have. Now let's add the transfer function. So I'm calling here a function, Tezos.transaction, has no parameter, sending some money to a particular address. And here the address is the address of the caller, for example, that's the source. Then this operation, I returning it back in the list of operation. So it will be executed at the end of my transaction. So here is a very simple send and forget pattern. I'm sending the money and I'm not doing any callback. I can compile my contract. Okay, so this was a very simple scenario. Now I will take something more natural, that is a smart contract calling an endpoint of another smart contract. Like in this scenario, the user is calling the smart contract 1, calling a smart contract 2, returning back to the smart contract 1 and storing the traces on the storage. So I will use the same contract, smart contract 1 and 2 with the same code, and I will deploy it twice, but I will use some function for the first one and another one for the smart contract number 2. So smart contract number 1 we have the poke function, and smart contract number 2 will have the get feedback function and the call to the callback. So smart contract number 2 will return its own address and a message. Here I'm declaring a pair with the address and the string message. And this contract is of this type. Now let's write the function on the smart contract 2. I will start with that because it's the simplest. So this is the unique entry point we have on the second smart contract. Once it's called with this parameter, it will return a pair of its own address and a message that is feedback that is already stored on its storage. So this operation is sent for execution. And as parameter, I need to know what is the endpoint I need to call. So here is passed as parameter, and this is the entry point from smart contract 1 I need to call. Okay, so let's now modify on the smart contract 1 the poke function. So the first part of my smart contract 1 I will be to prepare the call to the other contract, the smart contract too. So what I'm doing here, I'm trying to fetch here the contract to the entry point of smart contract 2. So it's called getFeedback, the function. It is an entry point, and here I need to prefix with a percentage. It's returning me the contract object that I will pass to here the transaction function. So this is a target. And as parameter, I will pass the contract to my entry point on smart contract 1. This is the entry point of the callback. I want smart contract number 2 to call me. And the same is an entry point, and I need to prefix with a percentage. This is the part 1, and I need to write now the part 2, that will be the callback function. So for the callback function, I'm receiving the pair that is an address and a message from smart contract 2, and I will store that on my storage. Okay, so with that, you're able to call any other contract and to have a synchronous way of continuing your flow using callbacks. But you see that is getting complex, and of course it's getting also costly because you have transactions here, so you have to pay the fees even if it's internal, and here. So the user will pay for the full flow and all the transactions. So we have to teach something is that what we are doing on the smart contract 2 is just to read this value. That's what is important here is to read this value. And just reading for another smart contract, we have what we call on-chain views that can do the same, but they are synchronous and they are very cheap. So let's modify our example to use views instead of doing internal calls. What I can do is to comment this function and replace it with a view. It does the same, it returns what I have in the storage, something named feedback. And on the smart contract number 1, I will just remove the second part and I will change the part 1 to call the view instead. So here I'm using now call view. I'm pointing to the name of my view that I need to find in my smart contract number 2 here. So it's of type address. It's returning me an optional because maybe the view does not exist. And I'm getting from the optional the message. And this message I'm storing on my storage like before. So the difference here is this call here is synchronous and is not using any transaction. So I'm not paying the fees for all these intercontract calls. And also because it's synchronous now, my function is not cut in two pieces. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something today, and see you for the next video. Bye bye.